Hello and welcome to the latest edition of our mCast. Today I'd like to talk about pre-skewing of denim. The process of pre-skewing is a special required process in order to eliminate leg twist. Without processes like sampharizing or pre-skewing, the denim fabric would shrink and also would automatically skew in the direction of the twill line. In order to avoid this, one has to pre-skew the fabric to take away the skewing, which would normally happen especially during a washing process and a tumbling process. And in order to automate this process, we think at Mahlo we have the right solutions to help you to do this process step completely automatically. So let's see and jump right in. Servus and hello from Bavaria. I'd like to welcome you to the newest edition of our webcast called mCast. My name is Thomas Höpfl. I'm working with Mahlo as sales director, and this is now the right time to subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you have not done yet, please, now it's the time to subscribe about it. In today's mCast, I talk about the pre-skewing of denim fabric. And this is a very special mCast for me, because normally we are talking at Mahlo very much about weft straightening. In this case, when it comes to denim, we have to talk about skewing, about pre-skewing of the denim fabric. And why do we have to pre-skew the fabric? Because denim has a twill structure, and this fabric tends to twist. So if you are not pre-skewing denim fabric and you manufacture later on garments out of it, jeans, trousers, whatever, you will have the problem of the so-called leg twist. The leg will later on twist, and this gives a bad feeling and need to be avoided. Therefore, it is important that this twist is taken away and done already during the manufacturing process of the denim fabric intentionally. And the amount of pre-skewing, this is something which can differ from denim quality to denim quality, from twill to the other twill constructions. There are sometimes you will have to pre-skew it to 6, sometimes up to 14%. The average, I think, will be around 8% of necessary pre-skew. This is determined by taking a piece of fabric, wash it in a household washing machine, tumble it, and afterwards you can see how much was the twist. And this is exactly what you have to then set on the denim finishing line in order to pre-skew the fabric. Now let's come to typical denim lines. Typical denim lines, when it comes to denim finishing, they start with the cinching unit, then very often there is a cleaning before and after the cinching, then it goes through washing machine, then it comes from the washing, it comes to the stretching, from the stretching it goes to the drying process, and then you go into the sampharizer. And pre-skewing always has to take place after the stretching. In the industry, there are still a lot of lines which are using manual pre-skewing devices. They do their job to a certain extent, but they have all the problem that they, they are blind. They don't see whether the target values which you want to achieve are really fulfilled. And therefore, one requires an instrument which can see what is the pre-skew and react on this. And this is our part. Later on, I will highlight how we do this. At first, I like to talk with you about the different ways of denim production. This all always starts with unroll the gray fabric, then you have to clean the fabric, you have to cinch the fabric. And then you have different routes where you can go with the denim fabric. You can go the traditional way, washing, wet in wet finishing. You can go for stretching, then pre-skewing, and then drying. There are possibilities to work with foam and minimum application units, stretching and then pre-skewing and then shrinking. You can go via padding, stretching, pre-skewing, drying. Or you have other possibilities. I don't have to read them all. You know them better than we do. But what is important there, everywhere, there is this one important step in the process, which is called pre-skewing. So pre-skewing is a very critical factor during the denim production. Now here I have one example of an installation of a weft straightener, Mahlo weft straightener, in a continuous denim finishing line. What do we see here? From this side, you will have normally the complete inlet section where you have the cinching, the cleaning, the washing, and it comes from the wet finishing, goes then into the pre-skewing device, and from there into our weft straightener. From the weft straightener, it goes to the cylinder dryer. We like to recommend to use our weft straightener always in combination with the existing pre-skewing devices, with the manual pre-skewing devices, because in those the whole pre-skewing is done in smaller steps with more rollers. It is more sustainable. It is it avoids greases on the fabric, and then it goes into the weft straightener, and in the weft straightener the amount of pre-skew can be selected via the software. If then our weft straightener now will see that there is a little bit too much pre-skew or a little bit too less pre-skew, it automatically will send out signals to the bow and to the skew rollers in our weft straightener. Very often in the denim industry, we cover our rollers with Teflon sleeves. This is easier, clear, for cleaning than from this indigo dye stuff. It's easier if you have Teflon covered rollers on it. This is another example where we have installed such a weft straightener in front of a stenter frame. And in this case, we also need the high tensions like on the other machine, but on the stenter frame you cannot create this high tension, as you will know, and therefore in this case we have drive units before and afterwards, and then we can create the necessary line tension during the straightening process and then hand this over to the stenter frame and do the straightening process with sufficient power. And this would be a typical installation after a mercerizer, for example. In the denim industry, we mainly use our Orthopack GR VMC 15. This is a reinforced heavy-duty weft straightener with stronger side panels, stronger rollers, and stronger drives. It comes in standard with two skew and two bow rollers, but the option to have three skew and three bow rollers is also given. It comes with a motorized scanner assembly in order to adapt ourselves to different fabric width. In this case, we only use hydraulic drives for the positioning of skew and bow rollers, because in the denim industry we always have to work against high line tensions. The diameter of the rollers in this case is 150 millimeters, and it's a machine which is completely self-contained. Means there's a side panel with all the drives integrated. There's one side panel with all the electronics integrated. The machine is very fast installed at place. You just have to bring the power supply to it. The rest is already pre-assembled. A few words about the hydraulic drives, which I mentioned. So in this case, we have now a new design for our hydraulic system. It works with a pump system where we have a servo drive for the pump, which is creating the hydraulic pressure. There is a very little hydraulic oil inside the system. We do not use anymore any pressure reservoir, and it has an integrated overload protection. If the tension gets too high, then it will stop the machine and secure that nothing is damaged. When we come now to the customer benefits, it's clear by using a Mahlo weft straightener in a denim unit, you will have the big benefit that you can be sure that the necessary and required pre-skew is always in the fabric from the first meter till the last meter. So if you have now any additional questions on the details, please, you can contact myself under my email address, and you also can check out our homepage where you can find also this video and also a lot of other videos. And the other possibility is the YouTube channel I mentioned already. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you and goodbye. See you next time. Bye.